2018 was a tumultuous year for labor in Trinidad and Tobago, with the closing down of Petrotrim and mass layoffs at TSDT, which means diminishing membership for the representing unions. Are we seeing the prevalence of adversarial relationships between employers and employees? What does this mean for the survival of the trade union movement? What are some of the implications?
Well, they had to.
Is this good industrial relations practices? And what does it mean for the industrial court? How is this all going to play out in 2019? In focus, industrial relations climate 2019.
Yeah, the broadcast I sent out is David Maketa and I will be on. So you come like a fool, people.
I thought you knew.
Nah, if I know, I would
January, our very first in focus for the new year, as we explore the industrial relations climate in Trinidad.
Everybody get
welcome to Carnival 2019 on Main Stage Power 102, celebrating the Masters.
I know since the last among them.
Get an early start to the festivities, a celebration of Trinbagonian culture. Come and enjoy the sweet enticing sound of Pan, Calypso, and the best of Carnival 2019. The party season is here. On Power 102, join us. Monday, January 7th, when we kick off celebrating the Masters.
I knew I had to be on stage. I felt this is a place.
Celebrating the Masters here on Power 102 with ticket giveaways to some of your favorite carnival shows and fans. Interesting historical features like origins of the mass, folktales, tables, and legends, characters of carnival. And to keep you updated and in the know, our Carnival Calendar 2019, along with so much more, we'll carry live coverage of your favorite carnival events. Celebrating the Masters is only on Carnival Power 102.
Power 102, empowering you.
This carnival. This is Power 102, empowering you. Sexplosion is on Power 102, and now on new days. And
hey, something had to come up with. Real cool, and I forget to walk with that jacket.
Yeah, okay. I find it
was good. We are what?
How are you doing, Philip?
Well, thank you for staying here with us on Power 102.1 FM and a very special evening to you. Special thanks, as always, to my daddy, my brother, kicking off our evening into live nighttime programming here on Power 102.1 FM. And a very special thanks, as always, to Richard and Skippy, the afternoon drive. Well, we're taking our time. It's now 9 minutes after 7 o'clock, and we do welcome you to Trinidad and Tobago, number one nighttime program when it comes to sex education. Sexplosion on Power 2.1 FM with the only sexologist in the Caribbean, Dr. Raj Ramanan of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center that's located in St. Augustine, the Hindu treats all sexual dysfunctions in both male and female. Well, a very special good evening to you, my big brother. How are you today?
Pleasant good evening to you. A pleasant good evening to all the listeners and viewers of Power 102. Happy New Year to everyone. This is my first stint on radio for the year.
Yes.
I have to make sure I wish everyone a very prosperous New Year 2019, and I hope things work out for everyone.
Yes, and it's a brand new season.
We're back on air again, so Sexplosion is on. I don't know if the app is on. Is it?
No.
Not yet. So.
But you're getting audio feed.
You're getting audio feed, but you're not getting the video feed. Right. I heard that. So at least Whitsons can hear us, whoever is on the app, and those of you who are tuned into radio, which is the best place to listen to this program.
Right.
Because it's theater of the mind. You can sit back and imagine what's going on in the studio. You can imagine what's happening. You can imagine also being part of the audience, being in the studio and asking questions here. Right. All you simply have to do is pick up the phone and call us. It's that simple.
As easy as that.
Call in and ask your questions. You know, you could be part of the Sexplosion crew. Yeah. And we have a lot, over the years, we have had a lot of individuals who have joined us in one way or the other, asking questions and becoming part of the Sexplosion family. Mm-hmm. So we continue to invite persons to that. Of course, I have a lot of viewers on Facebook who will view the program. And for those of you who want to know how to do that, just simply send me a friend request. And once you become friend with me on Facebook, you can view the program live also. Our Instagram is down tonight because I don't have the instrument for that. So you can also look at the program on Instagram for those of you who are on Instagram. But we are here. We are in a new year.
Yes.
And we are heading into our 19th year of doing Sexplosion. Imagine that. Who would have ever thought of
this
that?
This program would have been running for so many years.
I have to extend my condolences to the family of Mr. Sion, Chris Sion. I'm sorry I missed the funeral. As you know, I was out of the country, and it saddened me, really saddened me to know that our good friend, and if you know the 102 family, you'll understand when we say someone is a friend, we mean they're a friend. They're a little more than a friend.
Oh, yeah.
A little more than a friend. And the persons who we have built our career wrong, we can't forget them.
No,
we really can't forget him.
But I must say, he really had a beautiful turn.
I wanted to ask you about that. Just for a few minutes.
Yeah, had a beautiful
packed house.
And what was nice about it is that our station went auto from 9 in the morning and then 3 in the afternoon.
So that was very nice.
The whole staff was...
Everyone from the staff was there.
Was out there.
Well, again, I sent my apologies on more than one occasion. I wanted everyone to know that my heart was there.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't physically be there, but you know I was there because that morning I got up and I told my wife, I said, my dear friend is going today.
Yeah. You know, you see someone today and in a couple of days. Which...
Well, I'll tell you something. The strange thing about it, sometimes I listen to the station and I'm hearing Chris' voice.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'll give you... Something
I'm serious about that.
But something happened to me last night, and I expressed my with Gary and Galen. I was coming in, and I know when I come in to do my shift, he usually parks on the outside of the road. So I saw this vehicle, same one again, which is a white on here. And so just a split second, I said to myself, hey, I wonder what
Chris is.
And it's only when I came into the yard and I saw Gary and Dale, I said, you know, it's unbelievable. I just saw the car in my mind.
Yeah, well, it will be like that because remember, he was all part and parcel of it. He was Power 102.
Yeah.
He was the voice of Power 102. You know, Power 102.
You know, you must even be surely missed.
Well, he is missed. He is missed.
There's no two ways about it, you know.
Yes.
And as a matter of fact, people still call in and express their sympathy.
Of course, it's not going to end. It's not going to end now because he was, you know, Mac Daddy and I were discussing it, and I said, despite everything, but you know, whatever, he was a good soul.
Oh, yeah.
At the end of the day.
Oh.
At the end of the day, he was a good soul.
He was the type of individual that if you got yourself in a jam,
he would leave wherever he is, and he will come and assist you.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's a fact.
Because it happened to me just about 2 weeks before, our system broke down, and I called him, and he was on his way from South, and he popped in to the studio
and fixed it.
Fixed the,
He was the guy you could rely on to do a program with you. Sometimes there were intermittent periods when he had to do programs with me. Well, I started off with him.
Yeah.
So that's one thing I must say. Yeah. I started off with him. He was my first co-host on this program. He was the guy who put his hand up when everyone was backing away, including yourself, from doing the program. And he said, I'm going to do it. And he did it wonderfully for almost three years.
Yeah.
And because shifts change and because the time change and whatnot, we had to readjust and get different people to do it. But he was very good, and we had a wonderful time.
Yeah.
So I feel it. I feel it for my co-workers. I feel it for everyone in the studio. And I know when I say to each and every one. He is missed and he will be missed.
Oh, yeah.
And he's always a part of our family.
Where I will miss him greatly is in the panorama, because he used to do the song for mm-hmm. bands that is coming up for mm-hmm. panorama. Mm-hmm. And you know, as soon as you walk into the Queen's Park Savannah, Chris is the first man.
His presence is it.
Yeah, Chris is the first man that you lay your eyes on.
So, that having said that, I'd like to, of course, go on with my program now. But before I even go on with the program, you know, I started it off last year where I'm asking individuals in power, those of you who have the wherewithal to make that change, to please dedicate this year to Edwin I. Young, Crazy. Mm-hmm. Also, the recognition of a doctorate for him, a doctor of letters. I think he deserved that. He has created a genre of music. He has done so much for the art form. He is a wonderful guy to know. He's a very down-to-earth person. He's a humanitarian at the highest order. He's always there for his fellow artists. And he's someone that anyone can approach.
Oh, yeah.
Any single person, from the smallest child to the eldest person, could approach Crazy and talk to him. I had the distinct pleasure of sitting with him at the airport recently, and a guy just came up to him and said, thank you for what you have, for your contribution.
But I'm really surprised that, you know, they haven't honored him as yet. And, you know, our mentality
is to do it when a person is dying or dead. And that's not right.
No.
It's not right. And I think it should change, and it should change with Crazy.
Mm-hmm. I think so as well.
Yes, it should change.
Before we get into this evening's program, we are going to take a break, and we're going to be right back with you. You're listening to Sexplosion on Power 2.1 FM with the guru of sex education, Dr. Raj Brandon. We're going to be right back. Stay tuned.
"2018 was a tumultuous year for labor in Trinidad and Tobago, with the closing down of Petrotrim and mass layoffs at TSDT, which means diminishing membership for the representing unions. Are we seeing the prevalence of adversarial relationships between employers and employees? What does this mean for the survival of the trade union movement? What are some of the implications? Is this good industrial relations practices? And what does it mean for the industrial court? How is this all going to play out in 2019? In Focus, Industrial Relations Climate 2019. With guests Joseph Remy, Michael Anisette, Harry Sumpterman, Ken Dillett, Clyde Elder, Nirvan Maharaj, Shine Weatherhead, Jennifer Matisse Primus, and Kestu Nanku. Join us this Wednesday, 9th January, for our very first In Focus for the new year, as we explore the industrial relations climate in Trinidad and Tobago in 2019. All day this Wednesday on Power 102, empowering you. Sexplosion is on Power 102, and now on new days and at new times. The country's most informative sex education program, Sexplosion, is on every Thursday from 7 to 9 p.m. and Fridays from 9 p.m. to midnight with Dr. Raj Ramanan, the guru of sex in the Caribbean.
A lot of times we think that sex is totally below the waist. It is not below the waist. It starts in the brain. The largest sex organ that you possess is your brain.
Tune in for discussion on all sexual matters. Sexplosion on Power 102, empowering you.
And we do welcome you back to Sexplosion on Power 2.1 FM, with the only sex psychologist in the Caribbean, Dr. Raj Ramanan.
You know, I wanted to start off this year's programming with talking about different type of sexual act. Yeah. And, you know, the reason I wanted to do that is because sometimes you encounter someone of the opposite sex, but this is especially for the males out there, and the males out there will understand exactly what I'm saying. The females may not understand it because their physiology is not the same as ours. They don't go through the same sort of biological and physical changes that we go through spontaneously. And I'll explain that. When a man encounters a woman that he's attracted to, there are a number of things that happens to us immediately. We get a bit of nervousness creeping in. We get what you call butterflies in the stomach. We sweat. Our brain goes into a mode of defense and also excitement at the same time. We get a thrill of feeling, a sexual feeling, because our testicles react to the beauty that we're seeing, whatever the beauty may be. And these are the reactions that happens in a split second. You know. For men out there, who can't keep up with what I'm saying. If you see a beautiful woman that you're attracted to, 9 out of 10 times, the first thing that happens to you is you get a partial erection or a stirring in the scrotum or the penis. Immediate. And here you are seeing this beautiful woman, whatever beauty may be for you, it doesn't matter. Seeing this sexy, beautiful woman, and you're reacting to her, but she don't know you're reacting to her. Because that's what we do. When we are visually stimulated, we react. And we react on impulse. We don't react because we stand up there and say, I wonder if I'll get erection for her. It happens automatically.
As a matter of fact, it happens at the same time you're thinking.
But that's what I'm telling you in a split second. You know that and I know that and all the men out there know that. But the women don't know that. They don't realize that no matter, it doesn't matter if you're married, if you're living a celibate life, once you meet that person you are attracted to, or there's some sort of attraction, physical, mental, emotional, or sexual, you are going to react that way. The brain is programmed to do those things. Listen to all the things that I just said. You have a fluttering. You have a nervousness. You sweat. You start thinking about all kind of ways that you, how you could approach this person and talk to that person. But you're afraid to do it because you don't want the rejection of it. And all this happens in a split second together with an erection.
And you, as a matter of fact, the minute things like that happen, you get your body, you get a wet feeling.
Yes. You get a cold, but not a cold feeling at your skin. But as you say, a wet feeling. So look at all the change that happens to a man. The minute they encounter someone he's attracted to. And sometimes you may have met that person before. And this is not a first encounter, And I'll give you a good example. Sometimes you interact with someone on a casual basis. Not having any kind of interaction with the person. Direct interaction. And for some reason later on, the person starts talking to you. Tell you good morning and whatnot. You know, the next day when you see that person, all those things that I just described comes on?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Before it wasn't happening?
No.
Why is that? Think about it as a man. Try to analyze that as a man. Why does that happen? You're interacting with the person casually, seeing the person maybe a little right or whatever. But the minute that person interacts with you directly by talking to you, by showing some sort of friendliness, the next time you see that person, all the things about comes into being. And you know, you just see the person, you can't see the person because I'm going to get it right. Now when you see the person, you're nervous to do it.
Yeah. But I guess what happens in a position like that, your inner feelings start kicking in.
That's it. Your inner feelings and your brain kicks
your
in there.
Feelings. Because you're telling yourself
what I'm trying to get the woman out there to understand is that we have no control over that.
No.
So when you see your partner reacting like that, do not get angry. Try to understand why. If you see your partner reacting like that to you, try to understand what is happening. Because I'm talking about your partner, not in terms of a husband or a lover, You know me, this guy. You want him to talk to you and you wonder why he's not talking to you. It's because all these things are going through his head. And he can't do it. You're locked. You can't approach. You don't know what is the right thing to tell that person. And you're afraid to say the wrong things.
They have a word for that, you know.
Tutulbe?
No. You choke.
You choke.
Yeah.
But that's exactly what happens. You choke and you cannot come out of that. Immediately.
Sometimes you get yourself in a position like that. You want to talk, but words can't come out.
Right. No, that also could work against you. Because if you are in a committed relationship with someone, a girlfriend, boyfriend, kind of situation, fiance, wife, or whatever, and you see somebody you're attracted to, you choke all the time.
Yeah.
which is also, you know, and some women who will pick up on that very easily. There's some women who would want to berate you for that, but it's a natural reaction. Why are we punished for something that is natural? A woman, though, and I'm no expert in the feelings of women when it comes to that, because I'm not a woman and I haven't gone through that, but I'm sure that a woman going through something similar will have more control than a man. Because they don't show a thing. That nervousness.
So in other words, they would have
more control.
More full control of them.
They have more control. And they expect us to have that same amount of control that they have. But the physiology of a woman is different from the physiology of a man. Our genetic makeup is different. Our wiring is different. For all those who talk about equality and whatnot, a man is a man and a woman is a woman, full stop.
What did he fear to say?
We are not equal, you know, in any way. You know. We are not equal in any way. You know. I am not saying one is more equal than the other. You know. I'm saying we are not equal in any way.
But what did he fear to say that when you're thinking in terms of in a position like that, a man will be thinking, how would I perform with this person? Or how can I get this person into bed?
You have gone through everything. You have gone through all the sexual everything because your penis is reacting to the woman. Your brain is reacting to the woman. Your mind is reacting to the woman. Your heart is reacting to the woman. Man, if your liver and kidney could react, it's reacting to the woman too. And I'm sure it react because of them you feel to pee. So that's your kidney reacting. Sometimes you feel to pee. It's nervous energy. So every organ in your body that is functioning, your lungs is definitely reacting because sometimes you hyperventilate. You start to breathe deeply. So every organ that is functioning in your body to keep you alive reacts to how you feel about that particular individual. And ladies out there, all you must understand that and stop berating men for natural reaction that we can't help. We really can't help it. Once you meet someone you're attracted to, you are going to react. There are some who have control over it more than others. And you say, well, okay, well, why don't all men learn to control it? We can't.
But as you usually say, everybody's built differently.
We're built differently, but we're built differently from women. So if a woman is telling a man, well, if I could control it, you could control it too. No, it is not that simple. It is not. We have a way of becoming, as you say, tied up in that. You know? So you're tied up in it and you can't get out of it right away. So you either act stupidly, you freeze at the moment, you choke there, or you gain control. And again, because if you put three men in a room, each one will react differently to the very same stimuli. So something is stimulating your brain, your groin, your sexual function, your heart, your liver, your kidney, your lungs, everything is being affected by it, and you want me to act normal? How in God's name that's going to happen?
Very, very difficult. But then again, on the other hand, you makes a woman difference where she has full control.
That's well, the woman, again, it's the physiology of a woman, the makeup of a woman, and the control that she has learned over the years. It's a learned behavior, it's a passed on behavior, and it's in their DNA. It's in their DNA to have that control, even if they see someone that they're attracted to. They're not going to, well, first of all, they can't get an erection. The clitoris doesn't become erected when a woman is sexually stimulated, you know. It takes some manipulation of the clitoris for it to become erected, the same thing with the nipples. So there is no instantaneous reaction from any body part that is going to give them away like it give us away as men. Hizika, Anthony Henry, my boyhood scout friend, how are you? I was looking at some pictures of all scouting days over the weekend. I visited my parents and, you know, my parents have all these old albums when I used to do all these different things and take out pictures like the hundreds. And I was blown away. Fanella, how are you? So,
well, just to remind you, it's now 25 minutes after 7 o'clock. You are listening to Sexplosion on Power 2.1 FM with the only sexologist in the county, Dr. Raj Vernon. And well, tell you what we are going to do. We're going to open up our lines and give you the opportunity to interact with Dr. Raj. 222-8255, also at 612-8255. Now, remind you that this program may contain material that is not suitable for children. Parental guidance are therefore advised. Yes.
Now, there are different sexual acts that are related to that. That first act I tell you about, when you see somebody and you have that strong sexual impulse towards the person, you could have impulsive sex, you know, and it could happen within 10 minutes. You know. It could happen within 10 minutes. Because a woman knows when she sees someone whether she wants to have sex with him or not. You know. But she has the control. The man now has to take it upon himself to move towards that and to act or bring about the act so that the woman reacts to it. But she already knows whether she's going to give you sex or not.
But let me ask you a question. If a woman, like you rightfully said, a woman knows if she wants to have sex with you on the first meeting of you, could a man put himself in a position to tell, well, look, he's speaking to this woman and he knows off the bat she's willing to have sex with him?
No, no, no. We're not talking about speaking to someone.
Body language.
I'm talking about just sight by sight.
Okay.
Because I want to go through all the different types of sex. It might take us into tomorrow night, but I want to go through that. Oh, you so see, the impulsive sex. The impulsive sex is the one that happens spontaneously. And I'm sure in your many, many years of being on this God's green earth, that has happened to you at least once.
Oh, yeah.
Well, right. So most men out there could relate to what I'm saying. You meet someone for the very first time, you know within 10 seconds whether you want to go to, well, not 10 seconds, 10 nanoseconds, right, that you want to go to bed with this person, and it happens within 10 minutes. And it's an impulsive, quick sex. Because it is just there. Now, one would ask, well, where are the protections as far as STDs and STIs are concerned? Where are the protections against pregnancy and whatnot? There's nothing like that, you know. Because all you're thinking about is reacting to your groin, your brain, your feelings, your emotions, your nervousness, and getting the sex act over with. And that's impulsive sex. So if we understand impulsive sex, that there is something that could be triggered within a man and a woman for the very first time in meeting that could lead to sex within 10 minutes, that's the foundation. That's the foundation. That's why, let me read this here. Someone just sent me something and I happened to glance at. Good evening. I saw this happen to my husband. Thank you, I understand now. And we have all seen it. We have seen it happen to ourselves. We have seen it happen to our friends. We have seen it happen to our husbands. We have seen it happen to our boyfriends. The women out there have seen it. The men out there know it because we know it could happen. Because if you have three guys hanging out and they're just liming on the block and a nice girl pass, the three of them will have sex with her in three different ways. You know? In 10 seconds. In talk. Because a man will say, boy, that I go eat that from head to toe. And next one say, eat. But I go bend that over the call button and it's licks from behind. Next one say, boy, she will be sucking. And that is how the talk goes. Yeah. In 10 seconds, you get that. You get all that reaction from three men. Yeah. Especially if the three men are attracted to that one woman. If the attraction is there. And if two of the three is attracted to the woman, two men will make a comment and the other one will say, man, I waste our time. Isn't that so?
Oh, yeah.
Tell me that isn't so.
No, that's a fact. Yeah, that's a fact.
So the first thing the other two will jump out and say, like boys, oh, you see how hot that woman died up my style, man. Me, I like she. But women understand that we are impulsive at time when it comes to sex. Because sex, and somebody asked me the question today, a client asked me the question about love and sex. And I say, don't equate love with sex. That's why in religious teachings, they try to control you when it comes to lust. They'll say, well, okay, that's part of lusting. But it is part of impulsive behavior by human beings, especially the male. Impulsive behavior. And impulsive behavior has, you'll say, well, okay, why don't you control that with spirituality, with meditation? But you can't, because whatever has attracted you, or that attraction you have for that image or that individual, has already triggered certain things in your body. So you have lost the control. That is now controlling you. So that's why some guys will tell you to think with their penis. When they get an erection, they start thinking with that. Who are the ones that have control over that? Is it me? Is it you? Is it a group of individuals who have studied it? Who are the ones that have control over that? That's where the difficulty lies. So when women see men interacting that way, they will question it. So when a man reacts that way to you, and you're questioning it, understand that it is the physical attraction that he has seen in you, the beauty of you in whatever form or fashion, that has caused him to react that way, and he wants to be with you. How far it goes is dependent on you now and your interaction with him. And that is also important. Because many a times women are attracted to a man, but they don't take it further for many reasons. Commitment or lack of commitment. They may be married. They may have a family. They may be thinking about their status. They may be thinking of, they think about 10 different things. The same 10 nanoseconds that it takes us to be attracted to the woman and willing to go to bed with that woman is the same 10 nanoseconds that they take the woman to find fault or reason not to, you know. So you see how difficult it could
be? Yes, it is. Yeah.
That very same woman could see you and say, me, I don't like bald head fellas. And she find a fault right there. Although she's attracted to you, but she find a fault with you.
And that wouldn't take 10 seconds.
That's what I tell you, 10 nanoseconds. A piece of a second.
Because when a woman, as you rightfully said, when a woman watches you, the first, as soon as her eyes lay on you, she knows
if she's going to have sex with you, or could have sex with you or not.
Yeah.
Because there's something that then she would find reasons not to. She would find reasons not to, because I say, well, you know, I'm married, I don't think I should be doing my husband that. Nah, the children, boy, how you gonna look if somebody find out? Boy, yeah, that was nah. And all different reasons. But take that first 10 nanoseconds, which is 1/6, 1/10 of a second. Right? Take that first 1/6, 1/10 of a second and figure out what a man is going through and what a woman is going through. And for women, they give us a hard time for that. But it is just natural, normal interaction.
Anyway, folks, taking over time, it's now 22 minutes before 8 o'clock. You are listening to Sexplosion on this Thursday with the guru of sex education, Dr. Raj, the only sexologist in the Caribbean. We indeed treat all sexual dysfunction, the total image, and the adult therapy center. We're going to take a break and we'll be right back with you. Stay tuned. Explosion of Power 2.1 FM with your host, Dr. Raj Ramanan of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center. For those of you who would love to interact with him by phone, feel free 222-8255. also at 612-8255. You're listening to a program that's informative, educational, and of course entertaining, exclusively on Power 102 FM.
And when you find a woman that you have that attraction to, that immediate attraction, mm-hmm. and you don't engage in the impulse sex, what is the next step? The next step is baiting him. You know, when you go into fish, if you take a hook and throw it out in the sea, you're catching nothing.
Of course not.
You'll catch some plastic bag.
Yeah.
You have to put a bait on that hook to bait the fish into biting the hook. Isn't that so?
Right, correct.
So when that woman have not reacted to you in an impulsive way, but she likes it. She may not like you the degree of which you like her, because remember, it takes 10 nanoseconds for you to react to her with. And I'm going through it again because I want people to wrap their head around this, you know, because this is very important, you know. That 10 nanoseconds, a man will go through feelings, he'll go through nervousness, he'll go through anxiety, he will sweat, his heart will flutter, he will, as you say, choke up, he will get an erection or a partial erection or some stimulation in his scrotum or his penis, and all that takes 10 nanoseconds. And in that 10 nanoseconds, the woman is either going to react to you or not react to you, but she may like you. She may be interested in you, but because she being a woman, she knows that she's not going to push anything. She's leaving it up to you. So what do you do next? What is the next step? The next step is called baiting. You bait the woman. That's why people baiting. We do baiting through what? You want to find a way to get this woman to react to you. You want to find a way to get this woman to go out with you. You want to find a way to get this woman to be alone with you. Even if alone means being in a crowd.
Yeah.
So you'll invite you to a party. Mm-hmm. You'll invite you to go and have dinner. Or lunch. Just so that you could be in the presence of this woman. So that you could get that beautiful feeling that you have within you. So that you could now interact with that person on a more intimate level. So that you get the opportunity to do the next step of the bait. For that. If given the opportunity for that, take full advantage of it then. Take full advantage of it. Because in the next step of baiting that woman is to induce her and seduce her.
So in other words, that's where you get your second chance.
That is where you're taking that second chance now. Because all the impulsive things that you felt, the minute that you lay eye on that, remember, the impulsive is not the first time you meet a woman, you know. It might be the 10th time that you have met her, but things have changed where she's interacting with you and now you're getting this feeling for her. Something has changed. I don't want to use the word love because love is being used too loosely. Your feelings for her has increased for some reason or the other, but you don't know why. She's interacting with you now with a smile, with a wave, with a good morning, a good afternoon. How are you doing? How was your weekend? She's interacting with you. So that impulsive feeling that you had at that moment is now going into a second phase. You now have to take that second phase by asking her out, by wanting to be alone with her, to induce her to like you or to want to have sex with you. And then the seduction comes because you have to seduce her now. Although she knows she's going to have sex with you, you know. But she still wants the seduction. She wants you to seduce her. Because that's part of the process.
Yeah.
And just how she's going to rationalize, because women need to rationalize this based on feelings and other things. That's how she's going to rationalize being with you. She has to justify it. A woman has to justify these things. Men don't have to justify nothing when it comes to sex.
They could jump right into it.
Hmm?
I said they could jump right in there.
If on impulse we could have sex, and again I was explaining this to the young lady today. If on impulse you could have sex simply by seeing someone, wanting to have sex with them, and if you get the opportunity, you have sex with them. Or you go to a whole house, you see a girl who you're attracted to, you pay your money and you're going to have sex. It is that simple for men. And I dare any man out there to tell me that it's not that simple for them. I don't care how much that man has control. There is a woman out there who could break that control in a man. Any man. Any single man who is heterosexual. And any single man who is gay will be that man also. Who will break that in him. No matter how much control you feel you have. That's why I tell people, you know, you could be happily in love, crazily in love with your partner. She in love with you, you in love with her. Things strong between both of you. Don't feel that you cannot stray from that relationship. You know? Whether it is a strain for a nanosecond, for a sexual tryst, for impulsive sex, or baiting, it could happen. Now, there are some women that will be very difficult to get them to go on a date. They'll find every excuse in the book to do it, although they want to. Although they want to, they study what society will think of them. If anybody find out what will happen, what will happen to my husband if he find out? What will happen to the children if he find out? I would take that chance. What if I go on the what if I go on this date with this man and we end up bullying? They will think that. They will think all these things, you know. But what happens? That woman would have control at that point. But there's a next stage. Everything, there are stages. So if on the impulse, the impulsive part,
yes,
things could happen. Or on the impulsive part, there is control and nothing happen. You're going into the next step. I'm taking you out on a date, darling. What is it like to eat? Chinese? Okay, I know a good Chinese restaurant. It's sort of the best food. What do you want to go? Well, we can't go for dinner because, you know, I just have to go home at a certain time. Well, I'll go meet you for lunch. The minute you get into that realm and you get the person to agree to go with you, you're going into the inducement and the seduction part.
So, when we're using the word fishing, you're bait biting. You have good bait.
Mm-hmm. You're baited. That's bait sex. Because that is only going to lead to sex. What else is going to lead to? Because we're thinking along the line of sex. It is very easy for a man to impulsively have the feeling for sex. Women have a little more control over that than men. So we are doing everything in our power and possession, anything within our realm, to change you, to get you to go along with what we want.
Yeah.
Even though you say, yes, let's have sex, you still have to go through some processes for it. Even though she wants to have sex with you, there are still some processes that you must go through for that to happen. Isn't that so?
Anyway, folks, taking your time, it's now 10 minutes before 8 o'clock. You're listening to Sexplosion on Power 102.1 FM with the guru of sex education, Dr. Raj, running in of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center, located in St. Augustine. And there he treats all sexual dysfunctions in both male and female. We're going to take a break and we'll be right back with you. Stay tuned.
Year for labor in Trinidad and Tobago, with the closing down of Petroquim and mass layoffs at TSGT, which means diminishing membership for the representing unions. Are we seeing the prevalence of adversarial relationships between employers and employees? What does this mean for the survival of the trade union movement? What are some of the implications? Is this good industrial relations practices? And what does it mean for the industrial court? How is this all going to play out in 2019? In focus, industrial relations. with guests, huh? Joseph Remy, Michael Edison,
and that's where he's at.
Kim Dillon, what? Clyde Elder, Nirvan Maharaj, Shine Motherhead, Jennifer Batiste Primus, and Kestu Nanku. Join us this Wednesday, 9th January, for our first Info Meet for the New Year, as we explore the industrial relations climate in Trinidad and Tobago in 2019. All day this Wednesday, yeah, on Power 102, empowering you. Sexplosion is on Power 102. And now on
is
new
that,
days and
well, that's very good.
The country's most informative sex education.
I'll take one.
Sexplosion is on every Thursday from 7 to 9 p.m. and Friday from 9 p.m. to midnight.
The best thing
with
in
Dr. Raj, the guru of sex in the Caribbean.
Sex is totally melodious. It is not melodious. It starts in the brain. The largest sex organ that you possess is your brain.
Tune in for discussion on all sexual matters. Sexplosion on Power 102. Empowering you.
What can tell you about me, but it is better what we do best when it comes to sex education. We're here on Power 102.1 FM, the only sexologist in the Caribbean, Dr. Raj Ramanet. Well, for those of you who would love to interact with Dr. Raj live in studio, feel free, just dial 222-8255, also at 612-8255. If you do decide that you want to send him a WhatsApp or a text message, you can also do that on his private mobile, 740-1961. You can also send any messages on our website at Power102FM. Yeah.
Now, let's digress a bit. Mm-hmm. You have impulsive sex. You have baiting that leads to sex. And then you have what most women want when it comes to sex, a committed relationship. Mm. And that's where you have the next type of sex, which is called secure sex. Secure sex is you falling in love, going through the rigors of courting or whatever, getting married or living together. There's mutual trust that has been built between both of you, and the sex is fine because of that. There are some women who react to that also. That part of it is very important to them. They're not in the minority, they're in the majority. The secure sex is what they're looking for. But the secure sex is given very easily to the woman, to the man that they like. The secure sex is given to the person they want to spend their life with. The secure sex is given to that person which they want to build a family with. So that's another aspect you have to look at. There are some women who will not have sex unless they have a committed, tight relationship with the person. And there are some women that tight, committed, tight relationship means a ring on the finger.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Means marriage. And they will not do it before that. Although the impulse is there, although the feeling is there, although all the baiting is taking place while you're courting the person, yet still the control of not doing it is very strong. Some women are not that strong. So you get into a situation where you are looking for that commitment in order to have that relationship where you can be secure in your relationship and have secure sex.
You're not thinking in terms of the person will have sex with you and you won't see them tomorrow. You're looking, you.
No. It is not impulsive. No. It is not debating where you bait the person, you seduce them and you have sex. It's not that. It is where there's commitment. Yeah. And commitment in the form of a marriage certificate, commitment in the form of living together as in a common law relationship, mm-hmm. commitment in the form of a ring going on the finger, some sort of commitment. To have that secure relationship. I see my friend Crazy has said that he heard it when we had our discussion on him.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Some people send me some crazy things.
Well, even Crazy got in touch with you. So.
So when you have a situation where you where you have that sort of interaction, what is thrilling for you? Is it secure sex that is thrilling for you? Is it the impulsive type of situation that is thrilling for you? Do you want to be baited, seduced, and made love to? What do you want? What do you like to do? And everybody, every person out there who is listening right now have a different way of reacting to that. Some women like to be seduced. Some women like to be romanced and taken out. They know that sex is going to be part of it, you know. But they like the whole foreplay of that situation where you are
building up.
Where you are building up. Where you're seducing the person, where you're inducing that person. Although they know that they're going to have sex with you, they want that. They don't want the security, as I mentioned with the other situation. Although some want the security before they have the sex. So who are you? What do you want? Sometimes you call a man a player. It's because he knows how to play women based on those little scenarios that I put out there. Because at the end of the day, if I have an inclination that you have an interest in me, I could work on it in many ways. I could work on it impulsively. I could work on it by baiting you. I could work on it by giving you some sort of security, because there are men who do that. They lie like hell and make you feel that they're very secure until you give it up. So there are persons who prey on those things. You don't have to study from a sexologist standpoint to understand that there are women out there like that. Yeah. There are men out there who prey on that. They look for a woman who they see that she looking for a kind of serious relationship. And they create a scenario where they make it very serious, but they're lying like hell just to have sex. Because once the woman is secure in the relationship, she's going to have sex with him.
Anyway, folks, taking the turn, it's about 3 minutes before you, the Clark's Explosion on Power 12.1 FM, with the only sexologist, Dr. Raj Randoman, the only one in the county. We're going to take a break and we'll be right back with you. Stay tuned.
A tumultuous year for labor in Trinidad and Tobago, with the closing down of Petrotrim and mass layoffs at TSTT, which means diminishing membership for the representing unions. Are we seeing the prevalence of adversarial relationships between employers and employees? What does this mean for the survival of the trade union movement? What are some of the implications? Is this good industrial relations practices? And what does it mean for the industrial court? How is this all going to play out in 2019? In Focus, Industrial Relations Climate 2019. With guests, Joseph Remy, Michael Anisette, Harry Subnanan, Ken Dalit, Clyde Elder, Nirvan Maharaj, Shlyne Weatherhead, Jennifer Batiste-Rimus, and Keston Nanku. Join us this Wednesday, 9th January, for our very first In Focus for the new year, as we explore the industrial relations climate in Trinidad and Tobago in 2019. All day this Wednesday on Power 102. Empowering you.
Taking returns now, 8 o'clock in Trinidad and Tobago, Sexplosion on Power 12.1 FM with sexologist Dr. Brian Brandon. Be in mind, folks, other lines are open. If you would love to interact with them by the telephone, feel free to 222-8255, also at 612-8255. Yeah.
I see our dear sweet Yvonne is looking at us and she's agreeing with a lot of things that we say. So she would love this one.
Yeah.
You know why she would love this one?
Why would she love this one?
Because of something in her past.
Oh, okay. So something she had experienced before.
Huh? Hmm?
Something she had experienced.
Well, something that I'm sure she had experienced.
Okay. I can see
that. The next step, or the next thing I'm about to talk about, yeah, is something called sex by sight. Sex by sight. The minute you lock eyes onto a person, and you get that vibe that I talked about with the impulsive feeling that men go through, and she gets the same vibe, that sex by sight is a must, because you'll pursue each other until it happens. Both the male and the female.
Ooh.
They will go after each other no matter what it takes. Because that sex by sight, at the moment you lock eyes with the person, and this is quite different from impulsive sex, where you know the person before,
yeah.
You weren't that great with the person, you suddenly becomes good with the person, and you get that feeling in your groin and the feeling in your head to be with that person sexually. It's not that. This is the first time you have seen this person, you lock eyes with that person, the person lock eyes with you, and by sight, you know you want to be with each other.
That's interesting.
Now, what happens? You do everything in your power thereafter. Everything in your power thereafter to go after one another and to get, make it happen. No matter how long it takes. No matter how long it takes. There is that attraction that was created by that sight. And once there's the opportunity for you to pursue that person, let's say you're the same demographics,
yeah.
In the same area, in the same country, and there is a possibility of both of you meeting, it's going to happen. Because in your body, you have already created, within yourself, within your brain, within your function of your organs, you have already created that chemistry to be attached to that person sexually. That is sex by sight. And that is something that could be very thrilling. Or it could be very dangerous. Because, oh, go ahead.
No, you mentioned dangerous. Dangerous in what way?
Glad you asked. Because sex by sight starts at some point. You don't know what point it started at. Do you? Yes, you do. You know the point you started at because it's the minute you lay sight on the individual. The sight has been broken. You're no longer in each other's area. 5 years after, things have changed. You bounce up that same person again. Your eyes drop on the person's eyes drop on you. You feel you're not going to get back those same feelings? Your body's already tuned to that. Your body has already secreted that chemistry or that chemical for you to be attracted to that person sexually.
So the first time you see that person, for the very first time,
sex by sight,
yeah,
is created.
Okay.
Right? You have no interaction with the person. 5 years after, 10 years after, 15 years after, you come into contact with the person again. You're married now. Person's married. They have children. But yet still, that chemistry is there.
That energy is still there.
Because you're still pursuing one another. Mm-hmm. The sexual act have to take place. As far as you are concerned, as far as the person is concerned.
Right.
Now, both of you have to be mutually involved in this. Eh? It can't be a one-man show. You know?
No,
it can't be the man wanting to run on the woman and she no longer care about him. You know? It has to be that sex by sight chemistry is still there.
Yeah.
And some people it dies off. And some it don't. As a matter of fact, in some it gets stronger because of interaction in a different way with the person. Now, all the things I've described to you, I am sure, again, because of who you are, the number of years you've been here, I'm sure you have gone through all those stages.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And most men out there who have that maturity will tell you, yes, that has happened to me. And some men out there will tell you, I have had the opportunity to experience all them things Dr. Raj is saying. I don't know how much, but I know there are some who would say that. It doesn't make a man unique, you know. We all have those same triggers and those same feelings when it comes to sex. Because it has to do with you, your physiology, your spirituality, your makeup, and your ability. You know? has to do with that thing. So, I like the interaction of some of the people out there.
Yeah.
I love the interaction.
Anyway, folks, taking your time, it's now 5 minutes after 8 o'clock. You are listening to Sexplosion on Power 102.1 FM. With Dr. Raj Brahman and the only sexologist in the Caribbean, our lines are open. If you would love to interact with him by very telephone, feel free. 222-8255. Also at 612-8255. If you do decide, you know, some of you don't like hearing your voice on radio. Who knows, maybe even your neighbors are listening to the program as well. And you would love to send him a text message, very private, feel free. You can do that on his private mobile, 740-1961. You can also send any messages on our website at power102fm. Yeah.
Somebody says, exactly, that's where it becomes dangerous. When it's only one side having that feeling, the person can become obsessed, knowing he or she already created that vision of sex in his mind, and it has to happen. That's a fact. That's a very good point. But it is not you creating that vision of sex, you know, because if you were listening at the beginning, you were, I did something on impulsive sex. That impulse that you have for that person, and it is reciprocated by the other person to you. Mm-hmm. Once that chemistry is at the same level, you're going to feel it, you know. You're going to know, you know. Now, for whatever reason, if things have changed over the years, over time, over the months, or whatever, things have changed. But you are not pursuing the person because of that one vision that you had, you know. Sometime later when you come and you lock with that person again,
yeah,
and all the feelings are triggered, but it's just that one person may have control over it more than the other. It may be that one person has gotten over that and move on to someone else or something else, and that is no longer important. It's a lost opportunity, and it's a lost opportunity done there. Now, the person who still have that in his or her mind become obsessed by you. And yes, that is where it becomes dangerous. The obsession part of it. Why would somebody be calling me now? So somebody said, I could only imagine what awakens me. I wouldn't call any name because...
You wouldn't call no name?
Right? Another person says she's not ready yet.
Not ready yet.
I wouldn't say about what.
Okay.
She knows. And once she knows, that's important enough.
But that's the most important thing. So, that. But you have just proven the point there, as a matter of fact. Uh-huh. There's still something there to be completed.
There's always something there to be completed.
It's not completed.
Between two persons, there's always something there to be completed. Mm-hmm. Completed. Now, the next step, or the next thing that could happen, is something called environmental sex. You know, I always talking about things that affect a person and their relationship and their mindset and whatnot. The environmental part of it is everything in your environment is conducive to sex between both parties.
Yeah.
And we're talking about same sex and a heterosexual relationship, you know. For example, and I'm using this loosely, you go to a party. What happens in a party? Two things happen in a party that could lead to sex. Drinking and dancing. I dare anyone to tell me that dancing cannot lead to sex.
Will you prove that already? It might not be complete. That person will be still thinking.
Hey, let me carry on the program in a certain way. That, you know, Mark Daddy, where are you? Come back in the studio. Why are you so? Why are you so? I going on one road, you going on another road.
But you know exactly what road I'm going
on. I don't know what road you're going on, but hush your mouth. Lord, eh?
Yeah, so you were saying. So,
if the environment is conducive to sexual act taking place, it happens spontaneously. You have a couple of drinks. You hold on to a nice woman. A woman hold on to a nice man. While you're dancing, you just be feeling up one another. Tell me that is not true.
Yeah. But that's
right? You could do a quickie in a bathroom. You could do a quickie in a room. You could hump on the floor. Many times persons hump on the floor. A woman can make a man break on the floor in 2 seconds. Well, I know you, that can happen to you, but. Yeah. Now, in case all you want to know how I know that can happen to him, he has control.
Yeah, and I see you dance already.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. But that wasn't important. Even if you meet that person 2 years from now, that is the discussion that you're having, that impulse.
You just want to find out what happened after that dance.
Mm-hmm. That impulse.
I'll lay my interest. Nothing.
Nothing happened. So it is still running there.
No, nothing.
But I can see.
Drop it there. This color reminds you of it.
Yeah.
I know that.
Yeah, it does.
I know it does. That's the exact color.
But that was the whole afternoon. Anyway, folks, taking turn 10 minutes after 8 o'clock. Sexplosion on Power 102.1 FM with sexologist Dr. Raj. We're going to take a break and we'll be right back with you. Stay tuned.
Vancon offers professional turnkey vehicle management and maintenance solutions at their three facilities, Ethan Port of Spain, Union Hall San Fernando, and Lower Scarborough Tobago. Vancon is your convenient one-stop shop that offers every vehicle maintenance service that meets demands of high-quality standards at competitive prices. Their turnkey solutions include 3D wheel alignment, brake service and repairs, auto body repair, tire sales and services, battery sales and services, vehicle inspections that include motor vehicle, private and goods, T vehicles 3,200 kilograms and under, fuel injection services, steering and suspension repairs, diagnostic scan, air conditioning services, and much more. Trust your vehicle.
You have people listening to me, all kind of thing here. You're wicked, you know.
I know one person that's here. I know one person says you're amazing.
I say you're wicked. I say you're wicked. I don't know what you're talking about. Yeah. You did. Flow down the Blaston River. Where's the name of the river? The back of Belmont? Belmont River?
East Dry River.
East Dry River. Shoot. Which means diminishing membership for the representing unions. That's tied in them, there's a breeze.
What does this mean for the survival of the trade union movement? What are some of the implications?
Is this good industrial relations practices? And what does it mean for the industrial court? How is this all going to play out in 2019? In focus, industrial relations climate 2019. With guests, Joseph Remy, Michael Ennisant, Harry Sutherland, Kim Dallin, Clyde Elder, Nirvan Mark.
I want to go to deeper tomorrow. I'll leave the deeper parts for tomorrow.
Yeah. Join us this Wednesday, 9th January, for our very first In Focus for the new year, as we explore the industrial relations climate in Trinidad and Tobago in 2019.
Join us
Wednesday on Power 102.
Ah!
You know, I did well. You know, I
mean, you only get another brush. Have it off. In program with you.
Well, just to remind you, due to the mature subject of this program, parental guidance is advised. You're listening to Sexplosion on this Thursday evening with Dr. Raj Ramlan and Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center, where we do treat all sexual dysfunctions in both male and female. Now, folks, if you'd love to interact with him via the telephone, maybe you have something on your mind that is bothering you, especially with the topic that we are dealing with tonight, feel free, if you need some advice, give him a call at 222-8255, also at 612-8255. Yeah.
I noticed you're getting a little tight, huh?
No.
Somebody wants to know why you're busting my file, so.
I just know that. And I, why? Right? Why?
Okay, I hear you.
Yeah.
The amount of things I get in here, boy, I have to delete some of these things.
No, but that should be good. So let me hear you first. Let me hear you. What are we dealing with? What level we at now?
I can't remember.
You title. you jumble up?
No, I don't jumble up. We're talking about the spontaneity of sex.
Right.
Mm-hmm. The spontaneity of sex between two persons if they find themselves in the same environment that is conducive to them having sex. And you remember when you were growing up as a little boy in Belmont? When you said thief, the little chance and thing behind the house with the girls and thing?
Yeah.
You remember what them thing?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. How much of them you went behind the school and thing with? And you break the pipe. Now in them days has steel pipe, you couldn't break it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You break all the pipe?
Yeah, 4 miles. I get water for some. I get water I didn't expect it. When I think that water is water.
It's good for you. Yeah. But we have all taken a chance, or thief a chance, and had sex.
Mm-hmm.
Whether it be the seduction starts on the dance floor, the seduction starts because of alcohol, the seduction starts because all you cramp up in a vehicle together, and you get to feel up the girl, or she getting to feel you up, or she sit on top of your lap. It happens somehow because the environment causes it to happen. Environmental factor will cause a man to get stimulated very easily. And when a man is stimulated very easily, for example, especially if it is a younger woman who haven't had the experience of controlling those things, she could get stimulated very easily also. We have all had situations where we have a young girl sitting on our lap and we get erection.
But you might have been talking about plus. I used to say, pack up the box seat.
Pack up. Put somebody to sit on top there.
I have gotten myself.
And I'm sure a lot of young ladies out there right now giggling don't want to admit it because their husband listening to, or don't want to admit it because they just want to take that out of their memory.
As a matter of fact, some of them
were being told, they don't want anybody else to hear. Say, why this man busting me file so well?
In a position where people talk about he hire a private driver because he always sitting in front of the body and in the back seat. But was, those are the
they pack like sardines.
Yeah.
Environmental factors. That is why, as a young man, in our teenage years, we go into every house party. You know, this was a house party.
Oh, yeah.
And when we go and dance in one house party, they invited us to come to another house party to dance.
Yeah.
We got invitation all over Trinidad, you know. Mm-hmm. We went. We leave Sangre Grande and go and dance in Arima, dance in Tamana, from Tamana, end up in Marabella from Marabella. Izo, you know about that? We used to be all over Trinidad, you know? Yeah, you have to. Izo used to be with us in them days. You know, when Izo Bala and herself on the floor, what used to happen?
Yeah, but I know you could dance.
We ain't talking about that. We're talking about the other thing. The other things that could happen.
Yeah, but you see, I'll tell you something, eh? That was a good stepping stone.
But the environmental factor was there because we knew the environmental factor, what it could have done for us, and we took advantage of it. We used to go to bazaars for the very same reason. We used to go to Diwali shows for the very same reason. Because the environmental factors was always there for we to get what we wanted as young men.
Yeah.
And it used to happen. You still remember when we used to go to all of Diwali shows?
Yeah, I can remember bazaars.
Yeah. Well, we used to go for the liquor section and liquor hall.
Yeah. Yeah.
We had the trick, you know.
Well,
we had every trick in the book.
Mm-hmm.
We had every trick in the book. We never used to go to lose anything.
Mm-hmm.
Tin pan Ali, we didn't know every pan because we had a man who was an ace crack shot at pelting ball.
Mm-hmm.
No, seriously, he was a crack shot at pelting ball.
Mm-hmm.
And he will hit that middle pan down at the bottom, separate the two, and then hit the middle pan on both sides and separate them. We used to carry him just for that.
No, but I'll tell you
that was his job to lick down all the pan in Tin Pan Alley.
Yeah, but I'll tell you something. And you know, when you used to get yourself in a position like in that position, all the girls used to come wrong because
my forte was ringing. I know how to throw that ring and stick it and get it to go around the bottle and drop down. That was my forte.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was always tall. I was always tall and lengthy. I mean, I'm big now, but I was a real bad guy. I could have handled my stories and I could go through a crowd. You know when you have crowd around the ring and nobody can get in?
Mm-hmm.
I will be up in front.
Well, I know because I saw a couple of back in the throwback picks by you there. And I mean, you could have moved between rings.
I was agile.
You could have moved between raindrops.
Well, raindrops couldn't hit me. I only had to stand up sideways.
No, I saw a couple of.
According to my friends, I could have stood up on my hat and my foot was sheltered. That was an umbrella. No, but I'm very serious. The environmental factors is what we used to look at as young men. And I'm talking about, we don't know anything about Tantra and all these fancy things, you know. All we know is that there are certain things that were conducive for us to be intimate with a young lady, or a bunch of us, because we used to move in groups. We would move in groups. And in that group, 2317 was our transportation. In that group, we would all fan out and get what we want. That is how we used to operate. We have always operated like that. So no matter where we were going, what we were doing, we always use the environmental factor to our advantage. Without knowing, in years to come, I would be studying this thing and understand what we were doing. It's the very same thing when I was in university. The environmental factors always worked for me because I understood that there was something called environmental factors or environmental sex. Environmental sex will give you sex in the most unusual place at the time that you're not even thinking about getting sex, just simply because you're in the right place at the right time. Timing. Now, another thing is with environmental sex is like being in a swingers club. You could go to a swingers club and lock out or be very lucky if you know what you're doing, you know. Because no, it's knowing a swingers club. Mm-hmm. Imagine at 17 years of age, your boy leaves Trinidad, going into a foreign land, knows nothing about the culture except what you see on TV,
yeah.
Which is, you know, it's not real. Television is not real America. You know that. You live there. And joining a swingers club. And within joining the swingers club, that short period of time, from 17, I knew what I was about. I know the environmental factors and how to take advantage of it at a moment's notice. So I could drop in at the swingers club 6 o'clock in the evening, or 3 o'clock in the day, 9 o'clock in the night, 12 o'clock in the night, 4 o'clock when I'm going back home after going to Lime at City Limits, because City Limits was the only club that used to close 4 o'clock, and still get through. Because I knew how to work the environmental factors to my advantage. Not knowing that there was something like that when it came to tantric sex, and when it came to understanding spirituality and sexual behavior and intermingling of the mind, body, and soul, you know. Not knowing that, you know. But yet still, it was automatic for me. But where did I hone into that? Growing up with fellas like Vishnu, Ramesh, Boy, Izo, Gilbert. Growing up with them fellas who were much older than I was, because I was always the youngest. But learning from them. But at the same time, taking advantage of all the factors. So all the things that I spoke about, the impulse, the baiting, and whatnot, the guys who were older than me, I was observing them and their behavior and what they were doing. And I also had my own behavior being molded by that, but also the things that I read and the things that I put into play. So the environmental factor was very easy to take advantage of. Not everyone would have that skill, but I'm telling you, there are environmental factors that could lead you to having a great sex life if you know what you're doing.
Anyway, folks, taking your turn, it's now 25 minutes after 8 o'clock. You're listening to Sexplosion on Power 102.1 FM on this Thursday evening with the guru of sex education, Dr. Raj Ramanan of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center in St. Augustine. We will take a break and we'll be right back with you. Stay tuned.
So you are with the bus my file, sir? I just still remember that day, don't we?
I'll never forget that day. I said, you have to change shirts, man. You bring down the place for that night, man.
You sure it's me you're talking about?
Yeah. You want to leave part of the pool when she jumped in.
Vehicle management and maintenance solutions at their three facilities, Ethan Porter, Spain, Union Hall, San Fernando, and Lower Scarborough, Tobago. Vetcon is your convenient one-stop shop that offers every vehicle maintenance service that meets demands of high-quality standards at competitive prices. Their turnkey solutions include 3D wheel alignment, brake service and repairs, auto body repair, tire sales and services, battery service and services, motor vehicle, private and
goods,
vehicles,
3,200
fuel injection services, steering
and suspension, good
repairs, front mustard stand, air services, and much more.
Stop it.
She was so blue, I saw her as a wave. Tsunami. Coming across the boat.
Part of the Red Sea.
What she has, more current than Barack.
Part of the Red Sea.
Those are the days, yeah?
With guests, Joseph Remy, Michael Ennisant, Ali Sundanam, King Dalit, Clyelda, Nirvan Maharaj, Shine Burahead, Jennifer Batiste Primus, and Kester Nabco join us this Wednesday, 9th January, for our very first InfoGuest
of the
year, as we explore the industrial relations climate in Trinidad and Tobago in 2019.
But when you drink that, go to sleep right after, yeah?
I want to tell you that when it comes to nighttime radio, we are always one step ahead with sex education right here on Power 102.1 FM with Dr. Raj Ramanan of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center in St. Augustine. Don't forget the lines are open if you would love talking to him live in studio. Feel free at 222-8255. Also at 612-8255. For those of you sending in messages on his private mobile, you can also do that, 740-1961. May I remind you once again that this program may contain material that is not suitable for children. Parental guidance are therefore advised. Yeah.
But in life, you've had so many individuals who have gone into the realm of secure sex without experiencing the things that I spoke about. I'm not saying that everyone should experience it, but I wonder how many individuals out there knew there were these different avenues to develop your sexual knowledge. I'm sure there are lots of people out there who know, but did not know how to take advantage of it.
Yeah.
Or did not take advantage of it.
And
for good reasons, eh? It may be because of religion. It may be because they wanted to remain a virgin. They wanted to be in a committed relationship where you have that security. And they didn't want to be like you and I. You just confess to all the thing, breaking on pipe and thing behind this. I break down a pipe in a school, a sink in a school, but you well, that's somebody sitting on the.
Whoa.
You know, that's the correct height, eh? You never noticed that the correct height, eh?
No, that is the correct height. Yeah.
That was the correct height.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say when and where. Because then it will sell out to some people who are listening right now because they know for them a state where it would be.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't say that.
No.
Protect certain people.
That's copyright.
Copyrighted. But you know that was the perfect height.
Oh, yeah.
But then the sink left the hooks that they had on the wall.
Yeah. Sink. Kind of sink.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sank.
Yeah. Yeah, that too. But you had good memories in those days, eh?
I have good memories for my entire life.
Mm-hmm.
I do. Yeah. There is nothing that I've done in my life that I regret.
Mm-hmm.
There are things that I wouldn't do again. There are things that I wish I had done more of. There are things that I wish I knew then what I know now. Then it would have been much different. But I took advantage of every environmental factor when it came to that. And again, not knowing that what I was doing,
yeah,
in the sense of it being a plan,
yeah,
or it being something that was set, that this is what I want to do, but just doing it and it fell into place.
Yeah.
I see.
Well, it always happens like that, you know. Sometimes your intentions are not doing something in particular, but once you start and you move from one step to the other step and mm-hmm. you find yourself saying, look, this is what I'm into, you know.
Well, you got to know who you are as a person. One of the things that I've learned in life is everyone has a purpose in life. Mm-hmm. Everyone has a purpose. As a matter of fact, just recently I went to a dinner at a neighbor's home and I met some guys there and we were having this long chat. As a matter of fact, the chat was going so good, nobody wanted to eat. We were having a very lively chat about sex and opportunity and different things. And for 3 hours, nobody left to go and eat. As a matter of fact, the wives were coming and begging the guys to go and eat. But nobody wanted to leave to go and eat.
You see, the thing about it is...
And there was no alcohol flowing in. As a matter of fact, the host was begging people to take a drink and nobody wanted to take a drink. The topic and the subject of what we were talking about was so fantastic
and intense.
And the same thing, talking about our history and things that you encounter and what molded you as a man. And you have five different guys coming from five different backgrounds and five different religion and five different ways, but having similar experiences and having experiences that we could share with one another and questions going around the board. But it was just fantastic. And the younger ones were listening. The younger ones who were around us, the sons and whatnot, who were around us. They were listening and they were like, and you could see that things were triggering off in their mind. Because all the things we were talking about had to do a lot with the environmental factor. The social factor and the environmental factor. Because the social factor in our days of growing up is quite different from the social factor today.
Oh, yes, it was, yes.
Now you have people inviting you to come over by them, but everybody on the cell phone. Mm-hmm. Yes. I remember when my neighbor invited me to come, I left my cell phone home. I said, I'm going by my neighbor. I don't need to walk with my cell phone because I don't need to be on my cell phone. And I think nobody else was on the cell phone because the talk became so strong. It wasn't the typical party that you go to where you see people sitting and.
Yeah. And you didn't want to break that.
No, nobody wanted to break it. As a matter of fact, we ended up eating about 11:30 that night.
Yeah.
But. Hi, good night. How are you doing? I'm in love with my boss wife and don't know what to do. It's something that you had on the wrong road.
Not the wrong road alone. You're looking to find a new job.
Well, not a new job alone because sometimes you could end up in a dangerous, deadly situation.
But in a situation, if he's in love with his boss's wife,
well, you have to analyze what he mean by love. You know, now the young people use love. And that's another thing that was part of the chat. The young people use love. Because one of the equations that the person who asked me this, and he's a bit spiritual and whatnot, he was talking about, using the equation of sex and some of the things that we're talking about here tonight. And not to confuse it with love. Because love today is, I love you. Love, hey, how are you going, love? Love does not have the same connotation or the strength or meaning to us.
No, yes.
When we were growing up, we wouldn't use the word love.
No.
Very rare we will use the word love. You'll never say, I love that girl.
As a matter of fact, we would use the word like.
And I will stop at that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The only time I used to use love was, I reminded my mother about that recently. I said, you know, and my wife, around Christmas time, there was a very famous card with two red roses on it to the only one I love. I said, by a dozen.
Oh, knowing you, I thought you had about two dozens.
I didn't have to buy it, Junior. We sold it. All I had to do was just take it off the shelves. So when my father was buying that, I made sure he bought not 12 dozens, but 24 dozens. So we always had that.
Knowing you, if they had two boxes remaining, you would have kept them for yourself.
No, I would take mine off the top. I wouldn't keep it. No. I was always well prepared. Yep. I wouldn't wait till what remains.
As soon as it comes in.
As soon as it comes in, those two boxes were mine, put that aside.
Because knowing you and knowing how you would have think in those days, you say, boy, I don't want nobody else to buy these. So let me take one. So when I give this person this special.
The special?
Yes, you cannot say.
Well, that's when I used to be the buyer now. and they come to me to buy, I used to look for the special one and say, okay, I want so much of this one, don't sell it to anybody again. Talk that.
Exactly.
You know me too well.
No, that's exactly.
You know me too well. That is environmental again. Because when a woman gets that from you, and she can, and she can't see that anywhere else, not even being sold at your store, you know it's special.
And apart from that, you know, in those days, you know, when women collect, they used to show one another, hey, you see what I got from Dr. You don't see what I got from Raji? Well, you know, they used to call you Dr. Raji. You see what I got
no,
from
my name was Giri.
Oh, gosh, even better. You see what I got from Giri? You know? So it's not to say that you have gotten a card where someone else.
Yeah, but I used to have to make sure that they show it to somebody else.
Yeah, but.
Junior, environmental factors is what you're talking about.
Yeah, but then again, I know you, how you would move. If you send one to Toko, the next can't commit to Porter Spain. So they ain't getting in touch with one another at all.
You're talking about Porter Spain, there was a girl called Elizabeth Taylor from Porter Spain.
Lizzie?
You know she?
Any people taking what time? 45 minutes before 9 o'clock. You are listening to the Thursday edition of Sexplosion on Power on 2.1 FM with the guru of sex education, Dr. Raj Ramanan of Total Image, and the Adult Therapy Center located in St. Augustine, where he do treats all sexual dysfunctions. Our lines are open. If you would love to interact with him via telephone, feel free to 222-8255. Also at 612-8255. Yeah. Bring back some nice memories every year. Nice memories are bring back every year.
I am wondering how many young persons today, yeah. And this is something that I it disturbs me, because us who grew up in that generation, when we are observing the young ones of this generation, and we see the environmental factors being presented to them, and they're not taking advantage of it, but they're not doing anything about it, we just be like, what the hell?
Yeah.
We never had them kind of opportunities.
No.
And them fellas not doing anything. I wonder, do boys have the same feeling that we had when we were boys?
I think what is up, it's as we always say, it's a different generation.
Yeah, I understand that. But yeah. Feelings like that don't go in two generations. Sexual feelings don't go in two generations.
Like, you know what I'm going now? You know, we used to have one girlfriend, and before we see another one, we like it. It used to take months. Now you just go in a club and one of these places, and pow, we have our, as a matter of fact, we have choices to pick from. You know,
yeah.
If we had one choice, we had to talk to the mother first. And after meeting anybody, you have to meet the father. And we might make a little provision on a Sunday, and you got that.
So you meet the father already?
No, but before, I'm pretty sure in your days growing up, before you get involved with someone, you have to meet both their parents. That ain't happening today. That ain't happening today. In our days, we cannot go by our girlfriend, or the boys go by their...
That ain't happening. Yes. But what I'm saying is that the environmental factors now have changed.
Yes.
And it is more conducive to... I don't want to use the wrong word here, to a more open type of relationship. Because you see it all the time. And yet still, I don't see the guys taking advantage of it.
No.
Mm-hmm. Imagine I know some young men. I wouldn't say if they're related or not related or not. Who went with three of them went with three young ladies to camp overnight in the bush,
mm-hmm.
and nothing happened. You think that happened in our days?
No.
And these are teenagers.
Man, the bush would have been talking. Mm-hmm. No, but you see,
I was like,
I think the reason for that is that they. It is so normal for them.
Correct.
Because they figure that.
Correct.
It is,
but what I'm saying, is that making us numb to certain things that are sexual, to feelings, and that impulsive nature that we have as men? Is that making them numb? Because if you are with someone who is attractive, mm-hmm. or you have an encounter with someone who is attractive, it's a very serious question to be asking. Or is it that the men are so shy now that they don't know how to break out of that shyness and overcome that and move into that other type of relationship? Why are men, young men now waiting a longer period of time to get involved with someone, get engaged, get married? And is that time going to increase as time goes by? So you're telling me that our children who waited till their mid-20s, late mid-30s to get into a relationship and whatnot, their children are going to wait for what? The mid-30s to the mid-40s? What is going to happen to society? These are the things as a social anthropologist, as a sexologist, I question, you know. Some people say, well, what's wrong with that? There are lots wrong with that. And I'll give you one example of what's wrong with that. No man should be a grandfather age and minding a child, his own child. You should be a grandfather age and minding a grandchild. No problem in that, because you'll do grandfatherly things with a grandchild. But no man should be in his 40s and you now have a teenage son or daughter. Do you know why? No, I'm not saying it don't happen, you know, but I'm telling you it shouldn't happen. You are going to lose out on a lot with that child, and the child is going to lose out with a lot with that parent or parents. Also, now you have so many men in their mid-40s into their 50s who have so many illnesses and they're dying, and that child hasn't developed yet.
Yeah.
So if that parameter moves, another decade of year span, what is going to happen? You'll have a 50-year-old man bringing a child into the world. And by the time that child learns to creep or walk, you then? Because parents are very important to children.
Oh, yeah.
Mother and father are important figures. And when you watch the statistics of those who are involved in criminal acts, or nefarious acts and whatnot, for those who don't have both parents, to those who have both parents to take care of them and guide them and whatnot, you'll realize what I'm talking about here. Society is going to crumble.
Oh, yes, it will.
That's what I'm fearful of.
Anyway, folks, taking your turns now, 14 minutes, or that should be 19 minutes before 9 o'clock. Sexplosion on this Thursday evening with Dr. Raj of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Syndrome. Our lines are open. If you'd love to interact with him via the telephone, feel free. 222-8255, also at 612-8255. You're listening to a program that's informative, educational, and of course entertaining exclusively on Power 102 FM. Yeah.
And Shivani says, what did she say? Good evening, guys. All the best.
Mm-hmm. That's Shivani.
Shivani. Okay. So when you look at society, now, again, my concern is not only about the sexual act and the sexual development of individuals. It's the development of society and what's happening to society and what's going to happen to society. That is also my concern. I am very concerned about those things. Because when you think into the future, I'm not thinking into the future because I am going to be there. I'm thinking into the future because my son is going to be there. My grandson is going to be there. My grandchild will be there. I don't know if I'll have other grandchildren. And what's going to happen to them and their edification and their development? That's what I'm thinking about.
Yeah.
So there's a ripple effect. And then I'm thinking about society as a whole. How's society going to develop? What's going to happen with Trinidad society? Culture of Trinidad. What's going to happen with Tobago society? Culture of Tobago. What's going to happen with those things? What are we going to miss out on? Because the beauty of what we enjoy, nobody's going to repeat that in this generation, but there's a beauty of this generation that's supposed to move on, and a bit of the past is going to move on from each era. So that's why I tell you in the conversation that we were having, and we were talking about trivia and all these different things. We were talking about life. We were talking about developing minds, experiences. spirituality, the connection between one and the other. A lot of people have lost the one of the things that I think I was very fortunate about in the environmental factor, I was always rooted in the spiritual.
Spiritual.
Always. That never left me. There was never a time I gave up on the spiritual, ever since I knew myself. There was never a time I pushed that aside to enjoy this pride. It was always a merging of both. Okay. Always.
Yeah.
Always. Even in the eyes of others, if they look at it, they'll say, but that is a sinful act. Mm-hmm. Or that is a bad thing to do. I never saw it as that. So that's why I have no regrets. That's why I could tell you, I could do something very easily without thinking I've done anything wrong in that realm. Because there's always a merging of both. And I never see it as doing something wrong. Never had, never will. Even when persons question it or question me, but, yeah. Are you doing it right? Right, right? Yeah. What do you see wrong in it? Well, that looking wrong to me. And I say, well, if it's wrong to you, it's wrong to you. You should do it.
Well, if the way is brought up to it.
Well, if
it's... And then that was the belief that you had sent you was on the child.
Well, that's what I'm telling you. But the belief came about because of a number of factors.
Yeah.
One of which is a merging of the spiritual to the physical.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it wasn't just one factor. It was a merging of two factors that was guiding the behavior, taking advantage of the environmental factors that was presenting itself. And who knows, maybe because of the spiritual factor, there was more of the environmental factors that was presenting itself to me. I don't know, and I don't question it. Sometimes somebody will say, well, you lucky boy. It has nothing to do with luck. It had nothing to do with luck. I don't consider it to be luck.
But as you rightfully said, that is something you don't question.
No, you don't.
No, you don't question.
Anytime you're questioning that, you're questioning everything else.
Anyway, folks, taking your time, it's now 12 minutes before 9 o'clock. Sexplosion on Power 2.1 FM. With the guru of sex education, Dr. Raj, we will take a break and we'll be right back with you. Stay tuned.
Turnkey vehicle management and maintenance solutions at their three facilities, Beetham, Port of Spain, Union Hall, San Fernando, and Lower Scarborough, Tobago. VetCon is your convenient one-stop shop that offers every vehicle maintenance service that meets demands of high-quality standards at competitive prices. Their turnkey solutions include 3D wheel alignment, brake service and repairs, auto body repair, tire sales and services, battery sales and services, vehicle inspections that include motor vehicle, private and goods, T vehicles 3,200 kilograms and under, fuel injection services, steering and suspension repairs, diagnostic scan, air conditioning services, and much more. Trust your vehicle to us with a service that saves you. VetCon.
I'm blessed to see love, inviting you to join me every Tuesday and Thursday, 10 p.m. to 11 p.m. for the program Snowball, a program designed to soothe your mind and uplift your spirit here on Power 102.1 FM.
Was a tumultuous year for labor in Trinidad and Tobago, with the closing down of Petrotrim and mass layoffs at TSGT, which means diminishing membership for the representing unions. Are we seeing the prevalence of adversarial relationships between employers and employees? What does this mean for the survival of the trade union movement? What are some of the implications? Is this good industrial relations practices? And what does it mean for the industrial court? How is this all going to play out in 2019? In Focus, Industrial Relations Climate 2019. With guests, Joseph Remy, Michael Anisette, Harry Superman, Ken Dallet, Clyde Elder, Nirvan Maharaj, Klein Motherhead, Jennifer Matisse Primus, and Kirsten Nanku. Join us this Wednesday, 9th January, for our very first In Focus for the new year, as we explore the industrial relations climate in Trinidad and Tobago in 2019. All day this Wednesday on Power 102, empowering you.
One contender, but when it comes to sex education, nobody does better what we do best. You're listening to Sexplosion on Power 102.1 FM with Dr. Raj Ramanan, the only sexologist in the Caribbean, of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center in Senegal. Still got a couple of minutes in which you can interact with him via phone telephone by simply dialing 222-8255. Also at 612-8255.
So my concern as someone who observes society and behaviors and patterns and whatnot is what's going to happen to persons, the younger generation. Are they going to be so wrapped up in technology that technology is going to take over their minds and take over their body, where the act that we describe at the beginning of this program, the feelings that transcends our body, disappears after a while? What are we going to become, robots? And those are very salient questions that should be asked. And what are we doing as a society? What are we doing as a people to keep those things alive, traditions and otherwise, culture, tradition, behavior, patterns, talk? What are we doing for that? Because you hear certain things are disappearing. They're going. Okay? And then you hear certain things they want out. Because someone decided it is no longer of value. But all these factors, and again, we come back to the environmental factors. All these factors that environmentally shape us are very important to us. It is the society in which we grow up, the challenges which we face, and learning to overcome it. Because you learn to overcome these things. We are resilient. Human beings are very resilient. We adapt to situation, we adapt to climate, we adapt to anything, and we learn to change. We change with the times, and we change with the... But is it heading to a time when time is going to change us, and technology is going to control us?
Well, judging of what's happening in today's world, I think technology is the one that will change us.
I think so too.
There's no two ways about it. Because when you think in terms of what we used to know and what we used to see growing up, to compare to what is happening in the world today,
two different things.
We'll tell you what we are going to do. We're going to go to the lines. Hello, and welcome to Sexplosion. Good evening.
Hello.
Hi, good evening.
Talking to Dr. Raj.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. I'm the person who spoke to you just before Christmas Day, right? And talk about the pinched nose.
Mm-hmm.
And you said you knew somebody, right? I would like you to tell me where the person is to get him ready.
Well, I told you to call me at my office this weekend.
I called you about 3 times. I called you at your office.
When?
I called up to you up to yesterday.
No. I said from Thursday. I don't work on a Wednesday. So you could call me tomorrow at the office or call my personal cell phone number 7401961 anytime after 10 o'clock.
All right.
Yeah.
Dr. Raj, Happy New Year. I am 39 and my wife is 38. I'm trying to have a baby. Is that possible? Well, you shouldn't be trying. Both of you should be trying. Yes, it is possible. Come and see me. Bring all the information that you have and we'll make it happen. If it's meant to be, it will happen. I could only do the physical part of it. The spiritual part, the couple has to do that. But I could work with the physical and medical part of it.
Anyway, folks, taking your time, 7 minutes before 9 o'clock, Sexplosion on this Thursday. Just to remind you that you can join Dr. Raj again tomorrow night, right here on Power 102.1 FM from 9, where he takes sex education to a whole new level. The only sexologist in the Caribbean of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center. Once again, you've still got a couple of minutes in which you can interact with him via phone telephone, simply giving him a call at 612-8255. Also, 612-8255. Yeah.
So many a times we have to look at how we develop, the strengths and weaknesses we have, what we have done. You know, people talk about making a New Year resolution. You don't need to make a New Year resolution. You need to continue with your life, especially if it's going in the right direction, and strengthen that as you go along. And if it's going in the wrong direction, you have to pull yourself back and head in the right direction, because only you have the power to do that, nobody else. You could get guidance from others. You could get guidance from this program. You could get guidance from friends and family, religious bodies or other things. But only you could really pull yourself back. Have that strength within you to understand where you need to be, where you are today and where you need to be.
And where you go from here.
And where you're going from here and how you're going from here. You must always have that plan. And that plan must be working for you. That's very important. Very, very important.
Amazing. Sexplosion Power 2.1 FM with Dr. Raj. Still got a couple of minutes you can squeeze in a call here with us. Feel free at 2228255. Also at 612-8255. Yeah.
And tomorrow I will continue with the different types of sexual activities.
Yeah.
Because I don't want people missing out.
No, they can miss out. I show you. People have responded to one another already. Hello, and welcome to Sexplosion. Good evening. Hello, good evening. Hi. Oh, okay.
Bye.
That one didn't stay too long. You know, I always think when people call to Sexplosion and you don't hear any voices behind, you can always suspect somebody walked into the room. Or he just left or she just left. You see? Hello, welcome to Sexplosion. Good evening. Could you just pull the volume down on your radio for us a bit? Thank you very much.
Hello.
Hi, good evening.
Hello, I'm Seduce.
Yes, we're hearing you.
Yeah, hello.
Could you pull the volume down on your radio and listen to us on the phone?
He talking to us on the phone and listening on the radio first.
Yeah. Hello.
Yes, hello.
Hello.
Yes, we're listening to you.
Yes, go ahead. Yes, I know Coca. It's a bit in the Coca River. What? Yeah. Go ahead, understand. All right. He's from my old village, Sukram village.
Okay, family. All right. Now, it's nice to hear people from the old, you know, the old school. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
He seemed to know it very well.
Yeah, well, if he's from the Coca, he must know me well.
Yeah.
We used to break Kawi and go and bathe in the Coca.
Maybe he's one that reported you.
No, nobody ever reported me. It's still Gaelic stuff. Because once you bathe in the Coca, you come back with your skin brown.
Okay. And
white.
Like, he sounds like a very mature, you know.
Never forget a whole street girl next door there.
Yeah.
All the boys decide to run away and go and bathe in the Coca.
Mm.
Everybody get next door there.
Everybody get up. Yeah, Pops look like, you know, he's a senior citizen.
What? So he looks like every man Jack Gaelic. When I talk about it, about 20 boys on that street. Eh?
Mm-hmm.
Everybody get next.
Everybody get a piece of the,
yeah,
the Bova wood. Never miss a deal.
Yeah, somebody's asking a question. I have a little time to answer it. Where is it? So many devices and so many things. Dr. Raj, my wife had an anal fissure after having a baby a few years ago. Is the chance of tearing greater than normal if she have anal sex? Yes, it is. Yes, you have to be very careful.
Anyway, folks, well, this brings to an end for this Tuesday edition.
Yeah, but you surprised me.
Surprised
I didn't expect you to be on tonight, and I have to be thank you for that. But you could give me a heads up, because when I sent out the broadcast, I tell people to join David McIntyre and myself.
But people say we resemble or no?
Well, the voices tire people out here.
People say
yeah, but the voices tire people out here, because they just feel like you is David and David is you. Mm-hmm. But it's not. So you're going to be on regularly now from...
From 7, yeah.
Okay.
From 7.
Well, good. That's good to know. With that, folks, I have to say pleasant good night to everyone. I'm gone.
You've been listening to Sexplosion on Power 102.1 FM this Thursday edition. Just to remind you once again that you can join Dr. Raj tomorrow from 9 p.m. right here on Power 102.1 FM.